Hello, I'm Mr. Arnicher, a retired lecturer in mythology, preaching Christianity and Sikhism. Sikhism is a continuation of Christianity. Nanak was the second coming of Jesus. So don't be surprised, because you will see the knowledge you have is book knowledge. What somebody has written, you just vomit it out without pondering over it. In Jesus, you get his word through logical reasoning. When you get it, it settles in your heart, and then you know it is the true logo which you are seeking. But you must first know what you see with these two eyes, the visible word. Then you will know the word of the unknown, invisible God, Elohim. The word of the visible God is of Yahweh, the creator of male and female. In invisible, because it's our soul concerned, supernatural self, there's neither male nor female, nor Jew nor Gentile, nor brown nor black, because soul has no color. So what is the real self is inside you. This is a pot. Some has brown, some has black, some are yellow. That pot is nothing. Inside is the real, which is the Son of God. And here it is, I've written something. And, hi brethren, law and prophets, what tell John the Baptist? Luke 16, verse 16, clearly stated there that after that, John the Baptist, you don't have law, moral law. You go by Holy Spirit. Holy Spirit with small s is common sense. Holy Spirit with capital S is extraordinary sense that was given to the apostles at Pentecost as gift by our Father. It's not wages. Wages are by hours you work. Longer the hour you work, more wage you get. And wages you can claim, you do shoddy job and you can claim my wage. But in God, no shoddy job. If you have pleased him, then he will give you, otherwise you can go. So the law and prophets were till John the Baptist called prophet Elijah. Elijah, my God is Yahweh. Most of these Jewish Hebrew names are same as our Indian names. So I can get it, but this Elijah I can't, but maybe somebody can enlighten me and I can go to Google it and I will get the meaning. However, so they have put down that my God is Yahweh. That was Elijah. I mean, Elijah is the worshipper of Yahweh. And this is the pot. So John the Baptist, came in this one, a witness to the light which is inside me, but not the light. So this pot. John came in the name of demiurge, creator of pots, the temples of God, temples of Elohim, Allah, Parbrahm, is same thing, The word Allah and Elohim, they are very close to each other. And the word Allah is from Illah. Illah was the tribal gods in Kaaba, 300 and more than 360 or so. And then Muhammad Sahib, he kicked them out. He said, now is the time for Al-Illah. Al-Illah means the Father. They were tribal father. This is our supernatural father, God. So, Parbrahm, the word Parbrahm is from Brahma. Brahma means the creator of male and female, same as potter, as Yahweh. In Arabic, they call him Khuda. And in nature, we call him Kudrat. So all that you see with two naked eye is nature of Yahweh, Brahma, or Khuda. Same thing. Inside the light is of Elohim, Allah, Parbrahm. Same thing. But most of these Mohammedans, they don't know Allah. Because Allah is sun, not moon and star. This is moon and star. John the Baptist represented this one. So, the present Islam of moon and star is of Mullah and not of Allah. It's Inshmullah that dominates, not Inshallah. Inshallah, at Jesus, when he was coming to Jerusalem, two of his laborers went to a village, Samaritan village, to tell them to get ready to receive Jesus. They said, oh, they are not bothered, let him go, you know. They were angry and they came to Jesus, put that village on fire as Elijah did. Now, Elijah was the natural nature in which you are jealous and revengeful, as Yahweh is. And in God, we are not jealous and revengeful. Whosoever come in the fold of God, he is welcome. Whoever want to leave, he can go, no restriction. But Yahweh is jealous if you leave. But not our Father is not jealous. So whosoever come under his fold, he will protect them. Those who want to leave, okay, up to you. So, Brahma or Yahweh or John the Baptist, who worked for them, is a witness to the light, sun, which is inside me, within us, but not the light, moon. Moon is a reflected secondary light. That is what John the Baptist was. Moon. That's in India we have Ramchandra. Ramchandra mean he is the Chand. Chand mean moon. Ram mean the one who is inside me, the spiritual father. Make me living. So that is why this is the age of Christ. That means this is the temple of God. Each one worship temple. In our worship is God within ourselves. If this is the temple of God, where will be God will be? In heaven, which is outside or inside me. It will be inside me if I'm truthful and merciful person. But if I kill people and loot them, as people did during the wars, and when their soldiers died, then they say, hey, their soldier died to glorify God. Salvation Army people say they died for
king and country. So which one is true? Today we have a breakfast in Reading, churches together, and a great man who was a successful businessman, and he was the CEO of so many companies, he came to deliver the lecture. So when I told him, you know, that your church, you know, this is more concerned with multiplying Mammon, this Justin Welby, who is the bishop of, archbishop of Church of England, he more interested in investing money into multiplying it. Whereas the first church, when it was formed, people sold their property and they came to live as a communal life. No concern with Mammon, no cheating, no flaws, anything. And this is just the opposite, I told him. And I told him, your church is Church of Satan. Church of England is Church of Satan. Oh, he was sore.
I told him that how can you glorify soldiers who died in World War I, World War II, that they died to glorify our Father God? They glorified king and country, as the Salvation Army people say. No answer, you know. So they are hypocrites, you know. They know the answer. That person who got this high position in, he has the common sense. Common sense is the Holy Spirit. He has the common sense, but he doesn't like it because he is opportunist. And if you are not opportunist, you can't go to the highest position. So they are always working for money. Even Church of England is working for money, how to multiply and feed their church priest. These priests, you know, Jesus got rid of them by giving his own sacrifice. But soon after, you know, their the Messianic Jew, they occupied the church, and they bring in their Torah, the deadly poison, to the New Testament. And they start reading Torah in the church, making it like Jerusalem University. You have today university professor in the university just reading the letters of the New and the Old Testament. And apostle used to come to preach gospel. To preach gospel, you have to think yourself. You have to be capable of logical reasoning. Gospel is not for the dead people, dead in letters. So when the apostle came and they found, you know, that they have been killed by the letters, the old wine of the letters, they are drunk with it. And the bishop tells them, look, look, they are not interested in your talk, go away. So they were pushed out. And then, you know, they hired this man who was very enthusiastic, and he cut a genital organ, Matthew 19. Some became eunuchs for the royal kingdom of God. So he cut it, you know, as literal sense, as Nicodemus said, shall I go back into the womb of my mother to be born again? So he cut the genital organ, and after that, you know, they won't take him into the synagogue or anything, because they need perfect man. In the church also, they wanted a perfect man to replace the Neo-Rabbis. These doctrinal priests are Neo-Rabbis, worse than the Rabbis which used to be under Moses, which was of Levi tribe, a responsible tribe, and they used to have a people congregation responsible to them. And that makes the situation worse than before the arrival of Jesus. That's why people don't like the subject of religion, because these new rabbis, hireling doctrinal priests, which are antichrist, they have no understanding of gospel at all. They are men of dead letters, and they create sectarian riots. So, it's the real Islam is of sun, not of the moon, not of the moon and star. Moon and star is a reflection. This is the moon and star. The real Islam go to your mind, to your soul, not to your flesh. So, moon, after John, he said there's no more law, no more sin. Sin is transgression against the moral law. If there's no law, no transgression, no sin. So you don't need a rabbi or these doctrinal priest to proclaim a person is a sinner or not. What he said after that is the royal kingdom of God, in which there are five temptation of the heart, which you have to overpower. And there are three of ego and two of mind, making it five. Now these are a long subject. I have put up this one in my videos on YouTube under Trinity or other. And if you see it there, the two are of mind, clever people, and three are simpletons, once born people, simpleton. The simpleton are being cheated by the clever people. And the simpleton, when they get poor, you know, and then they kill these clever people, as Hitler did to the Jews. So, these five are well known in India. In this, the Sikhs of the second coming of Jesus Nanak, they know it very well, but they can't explain it. They know it, but they can't explain it. So much so that they are blindfolded. They won't go to a church and tell them that Samaritan woman who had overpowered the five temptations of the heart, she was the most pious woman Jesus ever met. And she was so knowledgeable, spiritual knowledgeable, that she declared that you are a prophet. And she also said, when Christ comes, he will tell us everything. Christ is greater than prophet. So Jesus is not a prophet. He is the very son of our Father. And unless you too become son of our Father, you cannot preach gospel. Gospel is not in the books. In the books you find dead letters. So after John, there are five in the house. This is the house. Two against two of mind, three of ego, and three against two. The five husbands of the Samaritan woman at well, called Saint Photina in John 4. For details of these names of the five, ask a Sikh or watch my videos, over 5,000 videos, you know, on YouTube, channel Nijirwan as it is, or understand John 9. If you can't, not bothered about understanding Trinity, at least understand John 9, the born blind person. So, the parable of the born blind person is interesting because he too was born in Jerusalem. But he being blind, he had no letter, no education in letters. So that he was just listening with his ears, taking it to your heart and pondering over it. And when you do it, you brew new wine. So this man was listening, taking it to his heart and brewing new wine. So he understood what the thing meant. So that's why Jesus came to open his eyes, so that he can preach gospel, you know. Those who are living in spirit, they are not drunk with the old wine of the letters. If you get drunk with the old wine of the letter, chances of having the new wine are very, very slim. So you have to make effort to find the meaning or the parable to be explained to you. So the five in the house, two against three and three against two, the five husbands of the Samaritan woman at well in John 4, she was called Saint Photina. Russian people, you know, the Russian Orthodox Church, and all these people, they call her Photina, Saint Photina. And even they don't know, you know, that the names of these five husbands. They still call her, she was a bad woman, marrying one husband after the other, not knowing that they are spiritual, not physical. For details of the names of the five, ask a Sikh or watch my over 5,000 YouTube videos, channel Nijirwan, or understand John 9, the parable of the born blind person. Because he was blind, he could not go to the school to learn letters. With letters, he would have got drunk with the letters, then desiring not the new. So that's why through him, Jesus showed us the royal kingdom of God, where it is. So, the parable of the born blind person who was not drunk with the old wine of the letters, and how in Holy Spirit is common sense, we call it surti, he mocked the clever Mammon worshipping rabbis. I mock these university professors in Oxford. In spirit, they had no idea. They don't know who died on the cross, Jesus or Christ. So I call them super donkeys carrying holy books. These university professors with degrees in theology are Neo-hireling Rabbis, incapable of knowing gospel in Holy Spirit. Because when you are drunk with the old wine of the letters, if somebody asks you a question, you will always go to the book. Let me find it. I went in Germany in one of the Kirchentag and went to a house where the lady was a professor in the university. And her whole house was full of books, you know. All the walls were covered with bookshelves. So if you ask her a simple question, she will try to find the book where it's written that I can give the answer. So, gospel is by grace. Peter could not get it. He was with Jesus all the time. Peter could not get it. So when Jesus wanted to wash his feet, he said, don't wash my feet alone. First he refused, because in Jesus was being worshipped, he was calling Jesus a rabbi. So he did not like his rabbi to wash his feet too much. But when Jesus said, you are going to be part of us, if you don't get your feet washed, you won't enter into the bridal chamber to marry me. Then he agreed and told him, wash my hands and also head so I can think, you know, proper. Jesus said, they are already washed, because he was a truthful person. When he could not catch fish, you know, he was very disappointed. Then Jesus told him to put the net on the right side. And as soon as he put the net, there was so much catch in the fish that he had to call his friends, you know, come, let's pull the net. And they shared the catch. Peter then begged Jesus that I'm a sinner, because that's why he could not get it. He admitted, you know, what was in his heart. He was not a hypocrite, not boasting, you know. He was admitted humbly that he must be a sinner. That's why he could not catch a fish. And Jesus said, no, I will make you fishers of men, because your heart is clean like a little child. For this he was given the key to the kingdom of heaven, where you speak the truth and not blasphemy or hypocrisy. So, this blind man then mocked the Mammon worshipping rabbis by mocking them, you know. These university professors with degrees in theology are Neo-hireling Rabbis, incapable of knowing gospel in Holy Spirit. They love to quote the dead letters of the holy books. When you ask them questions, they will open the Bible and quote you, this is what is written here. Then they counter-reference, they go to another page. You get fed up with them, you know. They don't know what is the real thing, but they just keep on turning pages to pages, cross-reference to cross-reference, making the person fed up. So, they love to quote the dead letters of the holy books. Remember that this phrase I coined in 1985 or so, you know. And the Channel 4 people wanted to have it, to put it on their, what this was having on their religious site, you know. I said, okay, you can have it free. No tag. It is Holy Spirit. Holy Spirit is common sense. Shatters the fetters of the dead letters. So these holy books, you know, they are dead letters without spirit to interpret them. So that Holy Spirit is a gift by our Father, and not everybody can have it. So those who have, they should use it to earn His treasures, not this money. And many people go for this money. They don't bother about His treasures. And they say, oh, we have done the prayer. We pray before we go to the bed and this and that. But prayer is anti-Christ. Jesus never prayed when He started the ministry. After His 40 days of fasting, then He started. But before that, He was praying in the wilderness. All these things you get by Holy Spirit. So unless you have Holy Spirit, you can't preach gospel. So our Father God blesses you.